guys, this is another episode of Live for Him, and today is on being lukewarm. So I want to start us off with a verse just so we get the general idea of what being lukewarm is. Revelations 3:15 through 16 says, "So because you are lukewarm and neither hot nor cold, I will spit you out of my mouth." Being lukewarm is being in the middle. Like, we either like our coffee hot or cold, right? So like, whenever you go to Dunkin' Donuts, you're not like, "I want a room temperature coffee." Like, whenever you go, you want either hot or cold coffee. Well, God likes Christians either hot or cold. So either you're all for Him or you're not at all for Him. I feel like this generation thinks loving Jesus is uncool.
It's not fun. It's not, you know, like, trendy right now, because it's just so hidden from the world, and nobody wants to follow that because, you know, a lot of Christians today are very hypocritical, and they will go and they'll be like, "Yeah, I love Jesus," but then they'll go out and they'll drink, or they'll do really bad stuff, and they'll be like, "You know, I'm such a good person," and they'll act like they're, you know, so high and mighty, but I mean, they're just like, you know, everyday teenagers, everyday people.
And it's hard to follow those types of people when they claim to love something, you know, so supernatural, but they don't follow through with what that supernatural being has to offer for us. So it actually, like, pushes people away versus, you know, drawing people in.
And it is hard to step out of your comfort zone.
Oh.
That's another thing we need to talk about, is comfort zones. But not today, obviously. It's really hard stepping out of your comfort zone and telling people you love Jesus, because they're like, what
do you mean?
You'll get
made fun of for it. I mean, yes. I tell people I love Jesus wrong by my church, I'll be like, get lost.
It's just hard to talk about nowadays. It's just it's like a subject you want to stay away from. You never want to bring up Jesus. Like, when you're hanging out with friends, don't want to, like, bring up the subject of God, because no one
You don't
want to
get made fun of
it.
For it.
And, like, I actually posted something on Facebook the other day, so those of you who follow me already know what it said, but it was saying stuff like, if people were as nice as they were to people, as much as they were mean and degrading to people, then this society would be completely different. Like, right now, this generation is full of just tons of just depressing thoughts and depressing feelings and just derogatory terms and names.
It's more normal to be mean and rude than it is to be nice nowadays. Mm-hmm.
And like, you get made fun of when you try to step out of, you know, society's mold.
Why can't we just freely love a Savior who loves us freely? Why can't this generation be the generation who loves Jesus?
No,
I don't want people to look back in history books 50 to 100 years from now and see that this generation was a generation that changed the world. It was a generation that loved Jesus, that fought for what they believed in. Instead of gossiping and, like, wasting time on useless things, like, we waste so much time on useless things that will never make us grow in our relationship. So if you say that you have a relationship with Jesus, then why are you wasting your time gossiping about other people? Why are you wasting your time
trying to fit into the mold of society when you can be your own free spirit?
I used to waste so much time, like, partying and drinking and everything, and, like, I spent an hour in God's Word, and I felt so much more filled.
And you don't even have to do an hour. If it's even 5 minutes out of your day when you first wake up, you're just going to go into that entire day full of just, like, a new perspective on everything. You're going to feel at such peace and everything like that.
Literally, I'm not even joking, just spend, like, 5 seconds even. Like, it doesn't even matter.
Read a
like,
single scripture.
What I do is I listen to a worship song, and it just gets me in the mood, and then I just start reading. And literally, it fulfills me so much more than anything. So instead of wasting your time with, like, useless things like gossiping and trying to fit into the world and blah, 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 we could be using it to grow in our minds and grow in our relationship with Jesus. The three things that I want to cover today, like, bullet points, just so you can, like, kind of gather all this information that we just said, is we should be spending our time worshiping and not gossiping, creating, not destroying, and loving and not hating.
Which goes back to what, you know, my Facebook said, is imagine how different society would be if we were as nice to everyone as we were degrading and not encouraging to each other, that we would just totally change everything.
And everyone always says that this generation needs a change. Well, if you say that this generation needs a change, well, maybe it's time for a change.
You're a good girl.
So thank you for watching, and we will post another one next week. So, bye.
Bye.
It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am.